With the rhinos specifically, everyone knows about the poaching crisis that's going on. There's 3 rhinos get poached every day on average. There's a lot of pressure on these species. We see climate changes, we see habitat fragmentation. Human population growth is pushing these populations to the limit.
Rockwood is a captive breeding organization and it's part of their aggressive conservation approach.
The goal of that entire operation is to protect rhinos basically from extinction. So we have different aspects, anti-poaching, breeding projects, the cryovault project, and then also educating the people around. So Ralph likes the holistic direct action approach.
So far, most of the conservation efforts have been the conventional ones where you protect an habitat, you move animals between habitats. Actually, it's not possible anymore to expand into new areas. So we have to look into new techniques to sort of create that same possibility of bringing new genetics in into these populations by finding other ways to do it. And one of those ways is to use artificial or assisted reproductive technologies.
The Hemmersbach Rhino Force Cryovault is a progressive conservation but also a scientific approach to conservation. As a non-profit organization, we focus on 2 approaches to develop the biggest genetic reservoir for rhinos in the world of viable semen and ovaries, ova, eggs.
So what we do when we do a semen collection, we just anesthetize the animal by the means of a dart. Once the animal is down and sleeping, we use electroejaculation. So that means we use low voltage stimuli intrarectally to stimulate the prostate.
The actual process is not that invasive, but it does require time.
We collect our live sample, we take it to the lab, we analyze it, we look at the sperm. If it's good quality, it's going directly into the freezing protocol. So that means we use liquid nitrogen to deep freeze the sperm sample, and this way it's going to be preserved for decades, maybe even 100 or more years, which could then even help in the future if the populations keep on declining, that we still have preserved some sperm samples of different individuals.
If you're doing research that's going to guide management in the future, it's not just arbitrary research, it's research that really can be put to use.
This method has been proved in many different domestic species and also wildlife species. It's a good and easy way to get sperm in principle. And the rhino is a bit more difficult because it's such a large animal and we need to adapt all our equipment to the size of the animal.
First we have our rangers, the men on the ground, looking after the animals. And if an animal is lost, we can go in and salvage genetic material of what we can, so we're no longer losing the animals.
It's very important that we have very defined roles in a team like this. Once you start to get people, you know, in a team that where their experiences and their expertise overlap, perhaps you get a conflict of interest. But in order to undertake projects like this, you need a vast wealth of experience coming in, and each person has their own area of expertise.
Every day we see something and every day we realize we know nothing. The more we see, the more we realize there's such a big picture behind this, and everything is connected. It's environment, it's nutrition, it's disease, it's DNA. Everything comes together and plays a role. It's not just reproduction. Everything's connected with everything, and that's exciting because every day you are pushed to think out of the box and to see what nobody else has seen before, or to think you see what other people have seen before, but to think differently about it. That's an exciting challenge as a scientist.
What we really appreciate about Rockwood here is actually that everything is in place and perfect, because this is a huge operation. There's more than 250 rhinos around here, and they are all very well maintained, well fed, and each individual is known by the owners. And this is a great advantage for us, because when we are going out and collecting samples and information, we need also these background information about the animals, where they come from, how old they are, if they are proven breeders, and all these things are really necessary.
Rockwood has offered us a platform to come and look at these animals and to collect samples and do breeding soundness assessments for vickers that will aid him into selecting bulls to use for breeding. It also gives him information about what we see on the ground on his population so that he and his veterinarian can use it in managing his breeding operation.
It's fantastic that a place like Rockwood and someone like Vickers is prepared to invest so much money and time and passion into something that he really believes in. It just takes a handful of really passionate people that really care for these animals, and you can make a difference.
It's individuals that need to take action, and they will make the difference for the animals in the future.